Welcome students, in this video I am going to discuss the topic concept of carbon credit. The idea for carbon credit came from the Kyoto Protocol of 1997 convention. This is placing a monetary value on the cost of pollution in the air. A credit is a measure representing 1 megaton, that is a mass equal to 1000 kilograms of carbon dioxide. This is either saved from being emitted or removed from the Earth's atmosphere. These credits are in two ways. First, to reduce greenhouse emissions, and second, to fight climate change or global warming. Now, what are the carbon credits? The Environment Protection Authority of Victoria defines a carbon credit as a generic term to assign a value to a reduction of greenhouse gas emission. It is equivalent to 1 ton of carbon dioxide equivalent. Actually, it is a certificate showing that a government or company has paid to have a certain amount of carbon dioxide removed from the environment. For acquiring the credits, there are two kinds of trades, that is selling and buying the credits. First is emission trading, that is to put a cap and then trade. And second, trading in project-based credits, that is carbon offset. Or we can say to perform a project for carbon credit in a developing country. There is another hybrid trading system that has some difficulties in equivalences mixing in the economics also. Looking at the global climate change scenario, carbon dioxide levels have increased globally since the industrial age. Due to the combustion of fossil fuels and deforestation activities, the concentration of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere has increased by nearly 35% since the beginning of the industrial revolution of 1900s. Some of the products that create a process which emits a lot of carbon include cars and trucks, clothes, gasoline for vehicles, electricity, computers, furniture, and food. Now, what are the environmental aims of carbon trading? First, the reduction of carbon emissions, a better environmental situation, and the extension of climate change effect, and to mitigate the global warming. The Kyoto Protocol aftermath shows that it was implemented in 2005 and it was ratified by 127 countries at that time, responsible for 61% of global greenhouse gas emissions. The Kyoto Protocol binds 38 industrialized nations to reduce their emissions on an average of 5.2% below 1990 levels by the time 2008 to 2012. The mechanism of Kyoto Protocol is very flexible, as we can say that a tradable credit can be an emission allowance or an assigned amount unit which was originally allocated or auctioned by the national administrators of a cap and trade scheme, and it can be an offset of emission in a developing country. Such offsetting and mitigating activities can occur in any developing country which has ratified the Kyoto Protocol and that has a national agreement to validate its carbon project through one of the UNFCCC, that is United Nations Framework Convention on Climate Change approved mechanisms. Once approved, these units are termed Certified Emission Reductions or CERs. The protocol allows these projects to be constructed and credited in advance of the Kyoto trading period. Considering the industrial emissions, The burning of fossil fuel is a major source of greenhouse gas emissions, especially for power, cement, steel, textile, fertilizer, and many other industries which rely on fossil fuels. Using coal, electricity derived from coal, natural gas, and oils. The major greenhouse gases emitted by these industries are carbon dioxide, methane, nitrous oxide, hydrofluorocarbons, etc., all of which increase the atmosphere's ability to trap infrared energy and thus affect the climate. Thanks.